Good day! No idea where this video is gonna be all about. I'm through a journey towards Maassluis. I'm not fully sure if I ever rode this full journey on this bike yet. I know we did on the Honda multiple times and the Kawa, but I don't think I ever did it on this bike. And it has been so long that I even put in the GPS just to make sure I get everything correctly. So from time to time I might have to, check if I'm going correctly. Obviously I could just go across the highway. Would be a lot quicker, but also a lot more boring. So I'm gonna figure out what all this stuff is about. And I know there's a small piece between Rotterdam Schiedam and Maassluis. It's actually kind of nice to ride. I didn't know we were racing. So yeah, hence me going straight to Rotterdam. And then Schiedam, Maassluis to my end destination, and I'm back again. Probably still without highway, because highway is boring. I'm just gonna take you along in this small adventure and see what ends up. So know that I'm not gonna follow the maps exactly, because the next roundabout he wants to go straight. And I want to go right, views and different roads and stuff like that. By the way, I need to go left and not right. It's also all full under construction. But yeah, the roundabout is weird, because if you want to go straight you need to be in the right lane, and if you want to go right you need to be in the left lane. But this is roughly where I want to be, 87 Slapside territory. Bye bye BMW. So I think it is just straight on and on and on and on for now. I'm thinking, I can remember something with a broken motorcycle in front of me, but I think, although it was part of this route, it wasn't to Maassluis. I did something else that day. So yeah, I really believe the Yamaha has never been in Maassluis. Might as well explain the reason why I'm going to Maassluis. In Maassluis is one of the bigger reptile stores in the Netherlands, and with COVID, Corona, etc., all the expos have been cancelled the last 2 years, and we are running out of certain supplies. Main supply at this moment are bulbs. So I'm gonna go to the Blue Lagoon and see if I can get at least 2 heat bulbs for the leopard geckos. See how they behave, what the quality is, stuff like that. If I'm happy, we may buy more of them. If not, then we will look onto the next brand. Just finding out what works again. But normally we used bulbs from the Home Depot, but these type of bulbs are no longer being allowed to be sold in the Netherlands. Have been for quite some time now. So when it was still legal, we waited a little bit until shops were actually selling them at discount, because they needed to get rid of them, and we bought quite a few. Hopefully with the intent to last us quite some time, and in the meantime buy some bulbs from expos and test them out. Well, the second part never happened, and I cannot remember this many traffic lights on this part. Also cannot remember going this way, but you know, need to go left. I never drove in this way before. So either something is going on at some point during my normal route, or I don't know, maybe a one-way street became something, or I don't know, man. I have never driven this way before. But yeah, we run out of our old bulbs, which are no longer available, and without Expos we haven't really found a new bulb that fits our size, our animals, our systems, our, you know, the whole combination. So now we're gonna buy at least two bulbs so I can test them in a certain setup. If these are for our animals, our temper specs, our terrarium sizes good, then I'll probably buy more of them. If not, then I'm gonna buy two more and keep these, like, you know, backlog. If something breaks, well, we have nothing in house, at least we have something temporary. The moment we find something, we will wait for an Expo and then buy a bulk again. You can buy in bulk on Expos with often quite a lot of discounts. But yeah, that's the reason why I'm going to Blue Lagoon at this moment. Light bulbs. I know, it's a boring reason. This is all abandoned stuff. This one has broken down. There used to be a building there. Same state as these buildings, of course, but I want to say down there, I'm not quite sure if it's still there, there was a cafe. And my dad knew one of the owners due to the American fan club. I've been there twice in my entire life. Both time, of course, with my dad, because that just makes more sense. Cannot remember these buildings. The Netherlands, people always find places to build houses. I think I came normally from there. I don't know, I cannot remember this roundabout either. I think this is the right road, but normally I came from under the tunnel. I'm so happy I did not do this by memory, because I would have been lost by now. In theory, if this is the road I think it is, then I can do it by memory again. I do think this is the route I remember, which would mean that from here on out I can do it by mind. Yeah, this is like the mini racetrack that is public property. Like, yes, I think it is a bicycle property now. It used to be part of a scouting, I think it was. Yeah, you see, it's part of scouting and a bicycle lane. But wouldn't that be an awesome part to ride your motorcycle on? Because I don't think it is legal. We need something like that, but not for motorcycles. Hello, Maasluis. I still, once in a random while, have a squeaky brake. Like, all of a sudden, like, it's squishy again. So there might be an air bubble, I think, somewhere. So after this beautiful bridge, we'll take a hard right. And I have shown this on YouTube at least once before. And we're playing volleyball here. So they put down a ton of sand and we're playing beach volleyball. The last time I was here was with the Honda, and a Polish guy dropped my bike by backing up his fan, and it broke down my side stand, which I then got welded. So yeah, I'm going inside. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one.